Hey folks, it's Rich Mack here, and welcome back to leg number 39 of our Around the World journey. We are in Agadir, Morocco today, and we are headed south to Tantan, Morocco. I guess that's how you pronounce it. I don't know how many other ways you could pronounce Tantan. Tantan? I will say it's Tantan, Morocco. So, let's get in the plane and get moving, kids. Give me a second here. Parking brake off. Airport employee run over. I'm not like a mass murderer in Morocco. Forgive me here for a second, I'm kind of out of control. Slow down here. Alright, much more reasonable. Give me a second here. Let's get out to the runway and then we'll get out of Agadir. Hope I'm pronouncing that correct. Outside of Tangier and Casablanca, I'm not sure how to pronounce any of the cities in Morocco. Oh, in Marrakesh. I was in Marrakesh too. Morocco's big. I think I've had more legs in Morocco than France. Very impressive. And I think this will be the last full leg in Morocco. We're running out of Moroccan space. This flight will take us down the coast. I think for the most part, we'll be off the coast. In fact, I'm thinking of other things. I'm not slowing down to make that turn. Yikes. As you can see, most of the flight's going to be off the coast, but just off the coast. We should be actually be within view of the coastline as we head down. I say like the last third of the journey is going to be overland. Maybe not in the last third, just the last quarter. This is a about 167 mile leg, so not too long. Pretty normal. Reasonably fast taxi, like running from the law here in Agadir since I ran over those guys. Alright, get on the runway here, throw in the lights. Take off flaps. Let's get out of here. Never call it, but 76 knots is V1. V1, rotate. Positive right, gear up. climb. Flaps up. Autopilot. So as you can see, the weather's turned a little cloudier here. But those are high-level clouds, nothing too bad, no severe, no real weather. Just some higher-level clouds. Alright, so as you can see right now, we got a lot of clouds. We got a lot of agriculture down below us, but as we head south to Tantan, I think we're actually going to hit the border of the Sahara Desert today. So we're going to get to see everything turned to sand. I think this is just about going to be it for the green. And actually, I take that back. Looks like we got some lower level clouds right ahead of us. But that won't stop us. I'll hop back inside real quick. Just want to take a look at what I'm up against here. That as far as we can go. Alright, it's pretty much a straight shot down the coast. Let's get back outside. It almost looks like a fog along the coast. As you can see to the south, which is ahead of us, we have another range of mountains. I believe that's the last range of the Atlas Mountains. I looked it up the other day. I think it was the Anti-Atlas Mountains. I don't know how you pronounce that. Anti-Atlas Mountains, I'll say. I believe they are the southernmost range of the Atlas Mountains, and really they are the border to the Sahara. South of that, it's dry. It'll be interesting to see if there's a sudden change or if it's kind of a gradual changeover. Bear with me for a minute. I have to step out. I will be right back. Don't let the plane crash while I'm gone, folks. Alright, sorry about that. I am back now. I know I'm sure it just broke your heart to see me leave. Look at that. So, lots of clouds here along the coast. Clear inland. Or at least no low-level stuff. So that must be just the weather engine generating fog, I suppose, along the coast. Up ahead, I'll zoom in here a little, you can see those mountains. I really don't know what that range is like as far as altitude or how deep the range is. Sorry, I was talking and thinking of something else at the same time. I kind of put myself on pause. So I'm peeking out across there. I can't tell if those are clouds. It might be clouds on the horizon. About, well, up here we're pretty far away, so they must be clouds. I was going to say, the Canary Islands, when we get down to Tantan, we're not going to be far from the Canary Islands, but that's too far away right now. Unfortunately, this may put us a little too far off the coast. I really see a transition to the Sahara. Take a peek again. We'll go out here a little bit. Actually, we'll make a turn back into it. Let's do this. Let's not do this. Alright, so yeah, about 6 more minutes, and we'll be making a little tad bit of a turn to the left, and then we'll catch back up with the coast as we get in close. What am I doing here? Think rich. Boy. I dropped my Xbox controller and caught it between my knees, and I was trying to hold on to it and do all that at the same time. Working out some muscle groups that never get worked out. Probably a little TMI. So, I guess technically, this is the last full flight we're going to have in Morocco, but Tantan itself is about maybe 60 miles north of the Western Saharan border, and the Western Sahara is kind of a territory mainly controlled by Morocco. I say mainly controlled by Morocco because I think it's kind of in dispute. Won't get into the politics of it, but so let's just call it a Moroccan territory. So really, I guess we have a little ways further to go in Morocco, so to speak. And there's our little turn to the left. And that's about the end of it. Like I said, not much of a turn. So our next waypoint is going to be Tango November, and that is in about half an hour, just under 100 miles. And at that point, we'll basically be right there. Watch the airplane do the little dolphin dance. As you can see, we're already getting kind of closer back into the shoreline. Excuse me. as you can see now, it's a desert. And I believe that the area around Tantan is going to be fairly flat. It's not on the coast, but it's pretty close. It's only about, I'd say, maybe 10 miles inland. Small city, population of around 70,000. It is a desert city. And as you can see too, the weather has definitely improved. Not that it was bad, but those lower level clouds have now all thinned out. those thicker clouds all behind us. So, the Canary Islands are about, I'd say, maybe 50 to 80 miles in that direction. Zooming out, I don't really see anything. I think it's just too far away. I was wondering if some of those clouds might have been on the coastline of the Canary Islands, but they are not. Let's go back inside again. Never turn my lights off. Not good form, Rich. Not good form. Change my mind. I'm going to go back in. No, not by the thousands. Just going to descend down from 3,500 down to 2,500 again. This is a flat coastal plain. There's not going to be a lot here. Shouldn't be anything in my way. We'll just slowly descend on down. Next few minutes, we'll be crossing the coastline again. Oh, sorry. I may be pronouncing this wrong, but that may be the Noun River, or known. It's pronounced, or it's spelled Noun, just like the English word N-O-U-N. I can't be certain that's it, but... one lone building down there. Kind of a whole lot of nothingness down there. I think it's all pretty much just dirt and scrubland, maybe even a little bit of sand mixed in. Yeah, that kind of looks like maybe sand mixed in with it. I'm doing this, I'm looking at satellite photos too, and it's just they make it look a lot more sandy. What's below me in the sim looks almost grassy-ish, but I don't see a lot of that in these photos. Alright, I'm gonna hop in real quick. Gotta fly the plane first and foremost. Let's see what we got left here. Still 9 more minutes. Okay, we'll go back out. And another thing, there might be a just kind of spotty satellite photography down here. So, like, look at that. That's a seam, and none of it looks really good. Those are dunes. I gotta say though, anybody out there looking for cheap oceanfront real estate, you might have found some. It's rather undeveloped. Water and electric may be a problem for you. Hauling in 2x4s and sheetrock from the closest Home Depot may be a problem, but hey, it's cheap oceanfront land. Now this coming up, I think, is the River Draw. I think this is just north of Tantan. It's the largest river in Morocco. I think it flows out of those mountains and right into the sea. I think it's going to be a while until we see any more trees. That's where the draw empties out into the Atlantic. And that dark mark on the landscape, I think, points right to Tantan. Out in that area. I think the airport being on that side of the town somewhere. Alright. Time for me to learn how to fly the plane. Stop playing around with cameras here. Put the lights back on. Might as well. Had them on most of the time anyhow. And, don't need to do that. For some reason, I just feel compelled to do that. All right, we're sitting at 2,500. To go. And we'll essentially cross over the airport and come back from the south, land in a northerly direction. Staring right at it. I think that's the airport. Alright, I'm actually going to go back into the to this mode because I can zoom further. That's the airport. Set up my camera the way I like it. This also, I don't know why it keeps doing this. It's got some really funky patterns here. That's the city right there. Hello, Tantan. And we Again, that's the Atlantic out there. So what this wants to do, if you can follow along here, looks like it's going to take us direct to Uniform Sierra Romeo, and then the Foxtrot Sierra 03, and then we could just go right in into the runway, simple enough, except if you watch the white line, we don't go from Uniform Sierra Romeo kind of straight over to Foxtrot Sierra 03, it kind of does this giant bow in towards the airport, back away from the airport, and then when you hit Foxtrot Sierra 03, then you turn around and head back into the airport. That's what I believe this is going to try to do, which kind of makes zero sense. So what I'm going to do in 3 miles when we get to Uniform Sierra Romeo, I'm just going to fly it manually. I think it's the best way to deal with it. Let me set my camera back up again. Alright, that's pretty good. Let me get back outside though. Make sure I've got the runway in sight out there. That's not the runway. Here we go. Alright, I'm taking over my plane. Another thing I need to do is I need to start bleeding off some speed here. One. I don't want that view. I need to get a visual on a runway again. I keep losing it in this desert. That's it right there. Maybe slightly premature, but I don't know why I'm having such a difficult time spotting it. But I am really struggling with that. Fast. I gotta lose some speed here. Alright, there we go. Landing flaps. Now I gotta watch my altitude. I do not wanna. I'm way low right now. Give it more throttle. So I got lights on, flaps down, gear down. Slam the nose down a little. Didn't mean to do that. All right. Well, we found it. Everything's fine. All's good. Get my lights off here. These fine gentlemen. Let's go around here. That is desert. Not a tree in sight. Kind of missed my mark. Overshot a little bit. These guys aren't going to be my friends. They're going to be like I'm an idiot. Set my parking brake. Ladies and gentlemen, there we are. Control my controller here. All right, welcome to Tan Tan Morocco. We are now in the Sahara Desert. That's the city of Tantan there. Actually, we're on a plateau up here. Look at that rise. I can see it better now that I'm raising the camera up. Yeah, this sits up on this plateau. That's kind of cool. You can see it there. All right, folks, that was leg number 39. I hope you enjoyed and hope to see you back for the next one. Take care.